There are two types of commercial aircraft, narrow bodies and wide bodies. The difference in width allows a wide body to have two aisles instead of one. But could there one day be an aircraft with more than two aisles? The design of an aircraft with doors at each end of the airframe requires an aisle running throughout. Otherwise, passengers would have to climb over each other during boarding. Therefore, airlines have found that the best configuration is an aisle running through the middle of the plane and seats fanning out each row. When planes got bigger, airlines started to use two aisles to create a new middle collection of seats. While wide-body aircraft could technically carry more passengers with a single aisle, the experience would not be particularly comfortable. Thus, two aisles are used for long-haul wide-body aircraft. An advantage of this twin-aisle design means that no passengers are more than two seats away from an aisle at any time to access food, bathrooms, and to disembark. But could we ever see an aircraft with three aisles? First, we need to justify the reason why an aircraft would need three aisles. Most certainly, it would come down to whether or not the aircraft was wide enough. This plane would need to be so wide that any passengers would be split into four distinct seating areas. A realistic example might be a 2-3-3-2 configuration. Some planes can have 10 or 11 seats but would facilitate more privacy for passengers to sit alone or with just one other passenger. However, it can't fit inside a typical plane today as the extra aisle would add too much width. However, if the plane was even wider but only fractions wider than today's aircraft, it could fit a 3-3-3-3 configuration. Interestingly, Lockheed had a design for an aircraft with not three aisles, but four. It would have seated passengers in a 3-4-3-4-3 configuration and allowed them plenty of common space to get up and move about the cabin. The plane could carry around 900 passengers on two decks, but the FAA raised serious questions about how passengers could escape in an emergency. Another design of note has been Russia's frigate Ecojet. This aircraft, which has roots going back almost 30 years, was designed to have the economics of a narrow-body aircraft with the capacity of a wide-body. Although we can't say for sure if we would have liked to fly on board these proposed aircraft, it certainly makes modern wide-bodies look awfully narrow indeed. What do you think? How many aisles should a plane have? Let us know your thoughts in the comments. Did you know that we publish over 175 stories every single week on simpleflying.com? Be sure to check the link in the description for more great stories just like this. Thanks for watching, and be sure to like and subscribe before you go.